ministry, that private home. So we don't do that. What does that let us cause people to go? So we're doing this. This is also people related to the cheese industry, but this is only from here in Green Line, okay? And Dan Carter and Jane Carter, their names came up immediately and said, the guys have to be in the room. Matt Damon Holmes was in it, and they did or did not. changing. This time it's not a lot, but she loves it. Like, so I'm trying to get to. So you call her Brad, and he said, Pam, you know, do a little survey for me to see how much cheese that we could make up. And that's why the main one is frozen area. He said, if you go out and try and see if you can sell some cheese for me. And I said, Slow down. years later, they said, well, maybe you could be the sales manager for the company. So we came back to Wisconsin and grew the company, and we sold the company, and it was very successful. We were the largest specialty cheese company in the United States at that time. And we did Stilton and Caves under the branch that Mr. Moyer was in his studies at the University of Wisconsin and his master's degree there as well. But he was always at the frontiers. One time, the state closed him down because he was making processed cheese in the same plant with natural cheese. And that was a no-no. They shut him down in India, and they put these things. He was a fighter that called for his principles, and was so very hard man. And so the company was sold, and then they came and said, well, Carter, we got the basis of it. We are selling things. And we said, no, we want to stay right here. So we didn't take the job. And by that time, I'd known a lot of the industry and the people of cheese making, but I knew the customers.
But your contacts.
Yes.
We made a lot of private label for craft and more Thank you.
Jesus, that young man was to go to, well, one of the first persons who went to was Clever Jesus.
Oh, yeah, it's just outside of the girl.
Yes.
Oh, I was
going to walk out to the walls of the building. And they would make a wall with the time. And we would come once a month and it's down. And the things that the walls are in, she used to call the boys the smartphones, smart kids.
So you would help with health.
Downstairs. Steve Strunk right now is the president of the National Association of Chief Executive Officers. Dave Walter is the vice president.
Yep.
Steve is also the president of the Contact Chief Executive Association. The company and also the president of the Wisconsin Chief Executive Association. So you're talking about two people that just have a tremendous influence. Wisconsin. I was going to introduce him, and he, when I go similar. France has three of the largest companies. The United States has two. Only two. So we are in the world at 30. An emerging industry. The Canadians are buying our companies up very fast. China just bought one of my parents. And so it's going to become a much more international business. So he said, I can get some money from the USDA to help Wisconsin because Wisconsin is slipping very badly in closing farms and closing cheese factories, and we've got to turn this around. So we wrote a proposal to him, and he called, and a few months later, best coach from either the university or the Department of Agriculture. The university takes almost 50% of every dollar for themselves. The state takes about 15 to 20 cents. So that was an easy decision. So then I went to the Department of Agriculture. And the Secretary of Agriculture, skill that you could go out and help a cheese factory or a farmer who wanted to make cheese and get into the business. And we had table designers, we had business plans, we had banking plans, we had all the things, but we would pay you by the hour and your mileage. And that was it. We used the Department of Agriculture as our headquarters, so we had no office and no overheads. And so that when he gave us 2 million, 1 year he gave us 3 million, 2.5 million, all the money was spent to grow the dairy industry. And so it was a said that to reach there, and then eventually to cloud that is there anymore. So I had that around. But both of us would say, we have learned so much. And our respect has grown even more so when we talk to these people and we see what we're doing and how successful we are and how so long ago to do it for what we do. I can see now why she's so so much for coming down, first of all. But thank you, beyond that, for what you have done and what you achieved in this room. This has been truly a delight for me. I love to sit back and hear these stories about people that understand. So thank you so much, Jane. Thank you so much. Very, very much. Now, I'm going to
thank you. I'm going to thank you for this place. I apologize. It's been here, but I've been being glad to share with you. All the 15 years.